In this section, I am going to show you how you can use mask in CapCut PC, and I am going to tell you what masking is, and where to find the mask to use for your videos. Masking is a powerful feature in CapCut PC that allows you to hide or reveal specific parts of a video, image, or text. It's commonly used for effects like split screens, clone effects, text reveals, and smooth transitions. So for you to use the mask feature, first import your footage to the timeline, then go to the video tab, then select mask. So if you are using the old version of CapCut, you can just select the mask you want to use, but for the new version, before you can select any of the mask, you have to click on add mask first, and by default rectangle mask will be selected, then you can change it to any mask you want. So, in all, CapCut has 9 masks, and I am going to show you what each one does. The first one is the split mask, and this creates a straight split effects, and this mask can be used to create a split screen effect. And as you can see, there are 2 icons on the mask, so this is used to rotate the mask to any degree you want. And this is used to feather the edges so the footage can blend in. So, the second mask is the film strip. And this can be used to create animations like the cinematic black bar opening. And unlike the split, which only cover one side of the footage, the film strip covers both end of the video. And as you can see, the film strip also has the rotate button and the feathering button. And you can click and grab here to open up or close to mask. Then the third one is the circle mask, which makes a circular cutout and can use it to create effects like around webcam footage. Then the fourth is the rectangle mask, which also creates a rectangular shape cutout. And for the rectangle mask, you can use this feature here to create a round corner. So click and drag to create a rounded corner on the rectangle mask. Star mask, which creates a star-shaped mask. Heart mask, which shapes the mask like a heart. So, whenever you select a particular mask, and you scroll down, you will find all this mask settings here you can apply to the mask. And every setting of the mask may vary, so you can use the position to position your mask on the y-axis or the x-axis. Then use the rotate setting to rotate the mask, and the size to increase the size of your mask. Or, when you come to the preview window, you can click and drag the mask to where you want to mask out. You can also use these dots on the mask to increase or decrease the size of mask. And also add feathering to the mask using the feathering tool on the preview window. And you can use this reverse tool to reverse the mask. And as I said earlier, anywhere you will find this diamond shape icon, which is the keyframe, then you can create a keyframe animation. And now the 3 newly introduced masks in CapCut PC, which is the text mask, brush mask, and the pen mask. So, for the brush mask, you will use the brush to paint over the object you want to mask out, then you will wait for CapCut to process and mask out the object for you. And when you scroll down to mask settings, you can increase the brush size using the size slider, add some feathering to the mask using the feather slider. You can also expand the mask using the expansion slider. And if you want to erase some selected parts you don't want, you can use the quick erase or the erase tool. So you select it and brush over the selected part you want to erase, and it will be removed. And if you want to use the brush tool again, you just click on the quick brush tool, then you are good to go. And the pen mask makes you trace and outline around the object you want to mask out. And after tracing your object, scroll down to mask setting, and you can use the feather slider to add some feathering, and use the expansion slider to expand the area you have selected. The last mask is the text mask, and this lets you mask any text to the footages on the timeline. And when you scroll down, you will find all these settings here to use. But don't worry for now, I am going to show you step by step what you can create with each of the mask. And last but not the least, if you want to add another mask, you will click on add mask, then you select the mask you want to use. Then you adjust it to your needs using the mask settings or using the preview window tools. So let's move to the tutorial. 1. Split screen. So I will be using this to videos, so add one to the timeline. Now position where you want to appear in the video on the preview window, so I will move mine to the left a bit. Now add the second video to the timeline. Then I will trim my videos. Then move my video to the right a bit. Now under the video tab, go to mask, click on add mask, then select split. Now rotate it 90 degrees. And position the mask in the middle. Select your other video and do same. So you can leave space in between your videos. And as you can see, our split screen has been created. And you can also change the color of the space in the videos. First select the video on the main layer, then go to basic. Scroll down to canvas, select the drop down menu, and click on color. Now you can use any color that you want. And this is how to use the split mask to create a split screen effect. 2. Text reflection. First go to text and add a default text to the timeline. Type anything you want here. So I will type frames. Then change the font and resize my text a bit. Now make a duplicate of your footage. Then move the text and place it under the other text. So I will zoom in on the preview window. Then rotate the text negative 180 degrees. Now right-click on the duplicated text and create a compound clip. Now go to the toolbar and click on mirror to turn the text horizontally. So let's zoom out on the preview window. Now go to video, click on mask, then click on add mask, and select split mask. Now move the mask and place it in between the text. Now drag the feathering icon to add some feathering to the mask. And this will create a text reflection effect. So you can move the text a bit closer to look more realistic. 3. Cinematic black bar. Add your video to the timeline. Now under the video tab, go to mask, then click on mask, then select film strip. So open up the mask a bit. Scroll down to mask settings, then add your first keyframe. Now move the playhead to where you want the animation to end. Then open up the mask till it disappears. And this will create this black bar effect. Now move a couple of frames forward, then go to mask settings and add a keyframe. Then close up the mask. And this is how to create the black cinematic bar effect using Filmstrip mask in CapCut. Four, shiny text effects. First, let's add a default text to the timeline. Then type anything you want, so I will type frames. Then I will change the foot and resize the text a bit. Now go to color and change the color to any color you want. Then make a duplicate of the text. Now select the duplicated text, go to color, then select a lighter shade of the color you selected. Then right-click and create a compound create. Now under the video tab, go to mask, click on add mask, and select film strip. Rotate the mask diagonally and add some feathering to the mask. Now move the mask all the way to the left. Then scroll down to mask setting, then add your first keyframe. Move the playhead a couple of frames forward. Then move the mask to the right. And this will create this shiny text effect. So I want my animation to be long, so I will move the second keyframe away from the first keyframe. 5. Round corners. So let's add our video to the timeline. Now under the video tab, go to mask, click on add mask and select rectangle mask. Now resize the mask to fit the screen, but leave some space around the mask. Now scroll down to round corner. Then use the slider to create the round corner. If you want to change the background color, go to basic and scroll to canvas. Click on the drop-down menu, select color, and you can change it to any color you want. 6. Round webcam. First add your video to the timeline. Now go to mask, click on add mask and select circle mask. So I will position my mask on the face of the person. And before you can move the footage, first click on basic. Then you can move it to anywhere you want. Now scroll to Canvas, select the drop-down menu and select Color. And you can use any color you want. Now you can resize the footage and place it at anywhere you want. 7. Overlay Transition. I will be using this to videos, so I will add the first video to the timeline. Then add the next video on top. Now go to Mask, click on Add Mask, then select either the heart or the star mask. Now scroll to Mask Settings and click on the reverse icon. Now decrease the size of the mask. Move the playhead to where you want the animation to start. Then scroll down to size and add your first keyframe. And W move the playhead forward. Then increase the size of the mask to fill the screen. And you can add feathering to the mask if you want to. And this will create an amazing masking transition using the heart and star mask. 8. Video Inside Text. First add your video to the timeline. Then go to Mask, click on Add Mask and select Text Mask. So scroll down a bit and type what you want here. So I will type Fusion. You can also change the font, then resize the text. So as you can see, our video has been masked into the text. So if you want to place a different video as background, scroll to Mask Settings and click on the reverse icon. Now move the footage to the next layer. Then add the second video to the timeline. And as you can see, we have one video as the background, and one video masked into the text. 9. Change background. So add your video to the timeline. Then go to Mask, click on Add Mask, and select Brush Mask. Now scroll down to Mask Settings, so you can use the brush size slider to increase the size of the brush. Then when you are done, draw over the object. Then wait for CapCut to process your selection for you. So if you have selected part you want to erase, you can use the Quick Erase or the Erase tool to do that. So select an end brush over that place and it will be removed. So the process take a bit of time, so wait for it to be completed. And as you can see, all the background has been cleared. So you can add a different background if you want. And just like that, I have been able to change the background. 10. Screen Replacement. So I will be using this footage for this tutorial. So go to Mask, click on Add Mask, then select the pen mask. Now use the pen mask to mask at the object. And also, you can adjust the mask using the points. So just click and drag, then place it at where you want. Now go to Mask Settings and click on the reverse icon. Now move your footage to the next layer. Now add your second footage to the timeline and adjust the footage to fit the screen. And with the pen mask, we have replaced the screen. So this is how to use mask in CapCut. So let me know your questions in the comment box and also like and subscribe. See you in the next tutorial.